Turns into a hard 12-rounder. That will seem like nothing compared to the challenge facing another boxing hero this weekend. Ed Robinson went to witness the preparations of a man undaunted by any test. Look into my eyes and
tell me, oh tell me what you see. A boxer's training camp in the heart of Cornwall. But this isn't preparation for an ordinary fight, and Michael Watson is no ordinary fighter.
I just love goals. Just create the fight in the engine. I love to have something to be excited about. My goals are to be accomplished. I'm a fighter. I love to fight. Fighter. It motivates me. It inspires me to move on.
Michael's latest inspirational challenge is to complete this weekend's London Marathon and raise funds for the Brain and Spine Foundation. An incredible feat for a man who was told he'd never walk again and was lucky to survive after his epic second clash with Chris Eubank almost cost him his life. But Watson fought back. Against all odds, he stood tall once more, and now he continues to defy expectations.
My life has been preserved for purpose. To prove the oddsmakers wrong. Those that told me I wouldn't walk again, I'm walking and talking and joking.
The boxing world rallied around his cause for a truly special night last year. A testimonial to raise money for the former middleweight and super middleweight star, as a host of champions paid their respect, raising awareness and desperately needed funds.
Well, I'm the people's champion, and I'm blessed to be the people's champion.
And the public support was obvious when Michael's marathon plans were announced at Highbury. Another poignant moment for the lifelong Arsenal fan.
I'm just overwhelmed with the support I'm getting from people. You know, last time, going back a few years back, the last time I went on a nice football ground was in my wheelchair. My favourite thing walking on that pitch, what a difference.
Yeah. Now the fight back continues at his close-knit camp on Bodmin Moor with a tough regime as Michael prepares to walk the 26.2 miles over six long, grueling days.
Michael's determination, I think the way he talks, it's like he's walked it already. And by being down here, he's got the right facilities to be able to conquer his goal. Anything Michael does, he does it from the heart.
He's made the impossible possible. You know, I really raise my hat to Michael in all corners.
Look how far I've come on now. Once upon a time, I couldn't move. The only thing I could move my body was my eyelids. But look at me now. Who would have thought we'd be communicating like this? Going back in 11 years back. Look where it's at now. I'm doing a marathon.
And Michael's turned to boxing for help with his latest challenge. Even recruiting me as a hapless and reluctant sparring partner to show he's still got the moves. And a few old tricks that Michael's ready to pass on.
See yourself becoming a trainer down the line?
Yes, I can.
With amateurs or with pros?
A combination of amateur and pro.
You've obviously got a lot to give to the boxing.
Oh, and I will do. Boxing my life. I love the fighters. I'm the godfather of boxing. That marathon is the gate to the doors opening for many things for me. I'll walk right through that door.
Let everyone know Michael Watson's
the force
back.
Is back.
The force is back.
The force is back.
He's a winner already because that is so inspiring. But Kevin, do you think the greatest chapter in Michael Watson's story could yet be written?
It's just so uplifting, this tale, isn't it? You know, there is talk about Paula Radcliffe and a dislocated jaw being the story of the weekend, but, you know, I think she'd be
the first to acknowledge it as well, actually.
It's a magnificent tale, and you can see why this chap was a world champion, one of the great fighters that we've produced in recent years. great spirit, and that's the spirit of a champion, sure
and
right for
it. And Glenn, what about that championship spirit? You know, I saw him quoted elsewhere in the build-up to this saying, my hardest task will be putting my hand up when I've crossed the line.
Well, after 6 days, I'm sure that will be pretty difficult. But, I mean, he's doing this job like he did everything else. You know, he's going away, going to training camp. He really is an inspiration, and you can't help but wish him so well.
Spencer, I guess more than anyone, certainly in boxing and maybe in the wider sporting world, nobody is identified with Michael's struggle as much as yourself.
Sure, I mean, Michael, for me, was my inspiration. He was my strength, you know, to see him recover the way that he recovered. That's what pulled me through, and I've got nothing but admiration for the guy, and I wish him all the best.
Can you understand why he's always looking for another challenge?
Because he's a fighter, he's a champion, and that's what champions do, you know. He always looks for another challenge. I've done a marathon after myself because it's that other goal, you know. Michael was told he was never going to walk again, and now this miracle man is running a marathon, and he'll just carry on and carry on. He just tries to defy logic.
Mm. It's been fantastic, Kevin, the way that the boxing world in general has helped, supported and encouraged Michael Watson.
Well, there was a reference to the fundraising dinner at the end of last year in London. That, but everybody in boxing turned out for it. Even Lennox Lewis showed up, brought him to London, which is difficult to get him out of Miami, let's face it.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, it's purely because of, you know, the way that the man has come back. I mean, he was virtually dead. He couldn't walk, he couldn't move any part of his body, and now to see him doing 26 miles.
It says so much for boxing as well, because boxing it's like a brotherhood, and you know, we're in there and we hit each other, but we love each other as well, and we all stick together.
Thank you. If you wish to support Michael Watson, you can make a donation. The address: the Michael Watson Marathon Appeal, the Brain and Spine Foundation, 7 Winchester House, Kennington Park, Cranmer Road, SW96EJ, and the website address is there for you too. And good luck from all of us to Michael Watson. Back to Spencer now. Busy life for you. Commentator, part-time trainer, and news reaches us, a father again.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, it's been a tough last few days, to tell you the truth, Paul.
What happened? We hear you and your famous bravery deserted you completely when you
took off the old block, isn't it?
You ran for cover, didn't you?
Absolutely, yeah. No, she's a bundle of joy, you know.
Tia, is that right?
Tia, that's right. Lovely. Tia, little Tia, and you know, everything's well. Mum's home, and looking forward to life with a new
sleep
addition.
Sleep going good, is it, Spencer?
No, that hasn't happened, Glenn. It's been about once in the last 4 days, so. But, you know, we'll get there. She's doing it the wrong way around at the moment. She's sleeping in the day and staying up at night, so it's making it a little bit difficult
for me.
Like
you.
What weight was she?
She was 6.5 pounds.
Tremendous stuff. And in a word, give him a tip on how to deal with it, Glenn.
I'll just give up.
Don't give me no tips. Keep them to yourself.
Get a nanny.
Yeah, well, my partner, Nicola, she was a nanny, so we started.
It's the expert, Spencer.
Absolutely.
Glenn and Kevin, thank you very much indeed for joining us on Ringside. Spencer, congratulations.
Paul, well done. Thanks very much.
Trust all the excitement won't keep you away from your place at Ringside on Saturday night.